Here's your wrestling news for September 19th, 2020. And your headlines for today include, Vince McMahon hated WWE SmackDown match so much he wanted to end it during commercial. Ladder match added to WWE Clash of Champions. WWE announces big rematch and interesting segments for Raw next week. Tessa Blanchard photo dispute finally settled. What happened with Alexa Bliss after SmackDown ended? Mandy Rose reacts to Otis stripping The Miz down on SmackDown. Future plans of the storyline revealed. Why AEW are planning a special theme episode of Dynamite. AEW wrestler reveals her house burned down this past month. The Rock rips security gate off its hinges during electric outage. Yet another big star's contract expired. He's a free agent now. Two-time WWE Women's Champion is returning to WWE soon. Vince McMahon reportedly forgot about two wrestlers' singles push and more. We are kicking off with SmackDown news today, as it's no secret that there's a lot going on backstage in WWE right now, and during this week's show, Vince McMahon was furious about one match. Ringside News is reporting that Vince was changing SmackDown throughout the show and was changing his mind in the middle of the broadcast, which may explain why the show seemed disjointed. A member of Creative revealed that Vince was, quote, screaming on the headsets that he hated the Cesaro match and that he wanted the match to go home during the break. Instead of ending the match mid-commercial, Vince cut the match's second half short by 4 minutes. And though we're not even sure what there was to hate about the Cesaro Grand Metalik match, something got under the boss's skin. This week's SmackDown also saw AJ Styles get a roll-up win over Sami Zayn, but when the Canadian launched a post-match assault, Jeff Hardy ran down and cleared the ring. After making his presence known, Hardy revealed that at Clash of Champions, he'll defend his Intercontinental title against both Styles and Sami, but in a ladder match. Jeff's history with ladder matches is well known, and we'll have to wait and see who can climb the literal ladder of success and leave the Thunderdome the Intercontinental Champion at Clash of Champions. Over to Raw now, and with WWE opposing football next week, the company needs something big to lure viewers. That may explain why they're doing a rematch from this week's Raw, as during a commercial break on SmackDown, it was announced that Drew McIntyre will face Keith Lee again. Last week's Raw saw Lee face McIntyre with a shot at the WWE Championship on the line, though that match was ended by retribution before a winner was decided. Raw will also see Braun Strowman return to the Underground to face the behemoth Dabba Kato, as well as a triple threat tag team match pitting Dominic Mysterio and Humberto Carrillo against Seth Rollins and Murphy and Andrade and Angel Garza, with the winners earning a shot at the Street Profits Raw tag team titles. With WWE previously waiting until an hour and a half before Raw to announce matches, it's clear the company is trying to stack this card, and we'll have to see how the red brand fares against the NFL this Monday. Video game news now, as 2K Battlegrounds released this week, but not without controversy. Earlier this week, we reported on an image of Tessa Blanchard being in the game, and the original photographer of that Blanchard picture, Basil Mahmoud, wasn't happy about it. After speaking with Michael Dawkins, who has worked on AEW trademarks in the past, Mahmoud took to Twitter to thank Dawkins with his help, and added that after speaking with the 2K Battlegrounds team, a patch for the game has been released which will remove Blanchard entirely. It's certainly strange that WWE would allow a picture of a non-WWE wrestler to make it into their game in the first place, and whether this means WWE have inked a deal with the first ever female Impact World Champion remains to be seen. More Battleground news now, as the game launched this week with a very special person promoting it. In a commercial for the game, The Undertaker appeared out of character alongside his wife Michelle McCool and their family, and we certainly wouldn't want to go one-on-one with the dead man either in the ring or in Battlegrounds. Back to SmackDown, as after weeks of being connected to The Fiend, Alexa Bliss seemed back to her normal self, until things went wrong. Alexa sat at ringside to commentate on Nikki Cross's match against Lacey Evans, and after the sassy Southern Belle wasn't happy about her loss, she got in Alexa's face and dared her to call The Fiend. The mention of Wyatt's alter ego snapped something in Bliss, as she stood up with zero emotion and hit Bliss with a Sister Abigail before walking off. Post-show, Bliss was seen walking like a zombie backstage, and the normally chatty superstar didn't say a word during an interview. Not even when her friend Nikki Cross tried to get her to talk. It seems like Bliss can still be her old self, which will certainly help with her new Uncool podcast, but we doubt anyone will be wanting to mention the Fiend to her and risk taking his sister Abigail, forehead kiss and all. Whilst Bliss may not even remember what happened last night, one person who definitely will is The Miz, as he was embarrassed this week on SmackDown. During the show, the A-lister revealed that he is suing Otis, who recently interrupted the dirt sheet, claiming that Mr. Money in the Bank had violated his First Amendment rights. Miz went on to explain why he used his connections to send Mandy Rose to Raw, explaining that he wants Otis to focus on cashing in Money in the Bank, and he and John Morrison continue to take shots at Otis and Rose, leading to the Heavy Machinery star pantsing Miz, showing off his tighty whities. On Twitter, the Golden Goddess praised her man for pantsing Miz and also commented on the A-lister's underwear. Whilst Otis may have gotten the last laugh on SmackDown, this lawsuit could spell big trouble for him, especially as the Dirt Sheet duo have said that he has to forfeit his guaranteed title match contract or face going to court. Otis now has 1 week to make his decision, and we can't help but wonder who will Otis's lawyer be and what his decision will be. In the Wrestling Observer newsletter, Dave Meltzer explained the new angle for Otis and Rose, saying, "The idea is Otis and Rose are now going to have a long-distance relationship, given that no world exists in these characters except Monday and Friday night, and they aren't allowed to be together." Given the reactions to this storyline, it seems the two will remain an on-screen couple, albeit a long-distance one, and we'll have to see what twists and turns will happen next with Otis and Rose, now that his Money in the Bank contract is now at stake. AEW news now, as Miro has finally locked down his new name following his debut on the September 9th Dynamite. Recent filings revealed that Miro registered a trademark on his name on September 13th, and according to Wrestling Inc., this was done through Michael Dawkins, who's worked with Cody, Chris Jericho, FTR, and others in the past. Miro's new trademarks cover the standard wrestling trademark topics, including merchandise and video games, as it's clear the former superstar plans on using the Miro name for a long time to come. More AEW news now, and with the company facing some big competition on TV next month, they've got something big planned. On what AEW is claiming is the one-year anniversary of Dynamite, AEW World Champion Jon Moxley will defend against Lance Archer on October 14th. And though this isn't the exact one-year anniversary, it's close enough for AEW. With Dynamite's actual anniversary being October 2nd, fans have been wondering why they didn't put the title match on their October 7th show. And according to the Wrestling Observer newsletter, that's because they have something big already planned for that night. They said, "I had figured the reason the one-year TNT anniversary show was 10-14, headlined by the Jon Moxley vs. Lance Archer match, and not 10-7, the actual first show aired October 2nd, 2019, was because the vice presidential debate is scheduled for 10-7. But actually the reason is, they've got other ideas for 10-7 which will have a different theme." AEW knows the vice presidential debate will take away viewers, and we'll have to see what big things they have planned to keep their loyal fans glued to TNT programming. We've got some sad news to report now, as AEW's Ivelisse has revealed a tragedy at home. On Twitter, Ivelisse spoke about the past month and revealed that her home recently burnt down, saying, "My personal life's been a whirlwind this past month. Going through losing a home due to a fire is no joke, not to mention other personal things combined with pandemic. I fought hard to stay mentally above, starting to see a bit of a silver lining now with it finally turning around." It's certainly been a mixed time as of late for Ivelisse, who won the AEW Women's Tag Team Tournament with Diamante, but also reportedly had her match with Thunder Rosa this week end in some shoot strikes, and we here at Slatrock hope there's better days ahead for the talented AEW wrestler. Now, it's no secret that The Rock is a very powerful man, and this week, the Brahma Bull proved just how powerful he is by ripping his own gate off its hinges. On Instagram, the most electrifying man in sports entertainment revealed that the power was out at his home, and since the electronic gate wouldn't open, The Rock used his brute strength to manually open it. The Rock joked that it wasn't his finest hour, but he couldn't wait 45 minutes for the gate tech team to arrive, saying that he had to go to work for the hundreds of production crew members who rely on him being there. It may not be the most glamorous solution, but you can't argue with the results, as The Rock made it to work thanks to some out-of-the-box thinking and some huge biceps. Over to the NWA now, as James Storm's contract with the NWA expired this year, but it wasn't noticed since NWA Power has been off the air. According to Fightful, Storm's a free agent now, as his NWA contract ended on February 1st, and even if he was still in the NWA, a clause in his contract meant he'd still be able to take bookings outside the company. With Thunder Rosa working AEW dates recently, there seems to be some sort of agreement between the two promotions, but if the Cowboy ever does appear on Dynamite, it won't be as part of the NWA. We've got some huge return news now, as after Melina came back for last year's Raw reunion, it now looks like she'll be entering the Thunderdome. According to PW Insider, the former women's champion has come to terms with WWE regarding a return. They said, "There had been some interest in Perez earlier this year as the company attempted to book her for the 2020 Women's Royal Rumble, but at the time, she was under an agreement with the NWA. That agreement has since ended." It was also reported that she'll be on TV within a week, and though it wasn't noted what her role will be, this is an incredibly fast turnaround for the 41-year-old former champion. Back to AEW next, as despite working the cinematic tooth and nail match at All Out, Britt Baker still has a knee injury she suffered in May and is waiting to return. Fightful are reporting that AEW had an ambitious return date that would have seen Baker cleared for All Out, but that didn't happen, and as of last weekend, she's still not cleared to compete. That hasn't stopped Baker from making appearances on Dynamite, which has reportedly earned her a ton of praise backstage, and she's certainly shown that she's willing to put in the effort to remain in a storyline, despite her injury. Now, we previously reported that Ivelisse and Thunder Rosa's Dynamite match saw the two use shoot strikes, but there's now conflicting reports about this. Whilst it was reported that Thunder Rosa used shoot strikes during their NWA Women's title match that Ivelisse no-sold, PW Insider noted that no such strikes took place, and Brian Alvarez also refuted previous reports, saying, "Nobody had any idea what this story was all about. They did their match, they went backstage, there was zero issue. Neither of them are under contract with AEW. Are you telling me that they're going to go in the ring and start shooting and that the company is going to bring them back for another match next week?" Alvarez added that he's 99.999999% sure no shooting took place, and that these strikes were put in because of both women's MMA background. Both Ivelisse and Thunder Rosa will return next week, alongside Diamante, who isn't contracted to AEW, and we'll have to see how next week's match goes following these conflicting reports. Speaking of WWE's women's division, it wasn't too long ago that Vince McMahon was ready to push Peyton Royce and Bianca Belair, but now it seems he's changed his mind. Despite McMahon reportedly seeing Royce as a future top star, she wasn't used at all this week, whilst her former Iconics partner Billy Kay worked on Main Event, and in the Wrestling Observer newsletter, it was noted that Vince has forgotten all about Bianca Belair. The EST of WWE has barely been used since her call-up earlier this year, and whilst Royce being missing this week doesn't necessarily mean her push is gone, it's still not a good sign. Vince McMahon was high on both of them just a few weeks back, even calling them two singles superstars during a recent call with Creative, and if WWE does intend to push the pair, they are certainly going about things the wrong way. And we're ending today with NXT, which may soon be entering the Thunderdome. As noted in the Wrestling Observer newsletter, there have been internal talks of hosting October 4th's NXT TakeOver in the Thunderdome, though the show could stay at Full Sail. So far, WWE haven't announced any matches for TakeOver or a location, and with the show being just a few weeks away, decisions will need to be made very soon.